Hey guys, I'm Saurav, and in this video, I will be talking about the pro mode slash manual mode in mobile photography. Now, like DSLRs, even mobile phones support manual mode. If your mobile phones support manual mode, but your default camera app doesn't let you change the settings, here are some applications that you can use in your mobile phones. But make sure that your mobile phone supports manual settings. So people get confused whether they should adjust the shutter speed or ISO, and how should they change the camera settings according to different situations. To solve that problem, what I will be doing is, I'll be shooting in different scenarios and I will be telling you how to adjust the camera settings to get the right image, doesn't matter what the situation is. This will be a detailed long video, but I guarantee you that if you watch the whole video, you will be master in manual mode. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So now when you're shooting in daylight, the thing you have to remember is to use the least ISO. Right now my mobile supports ISO 50, so I will be at ISO 50. When you're shooting in daylight, there's enough light available and you don't want to raise the ISO unnecessarily. So the first thing you set is ISO. The next thing you set is the shutter speed. The way you set your shutter speed is you just see the exposure and you make sure that nothing is going too bright or nothing is going too dark. Get the right exposure and set the shutter speed accordingly. If you're using a faster shutter speed, it's going to reduce the exposure. If you're using a slower shutter speed, it's going to brighten up the exposure. So depending on the exposure, set your shutter speed. So when you're shooting in daylight, it's very simple. Set your ISO first, then set your shutter speed and take the image. So when you're photographing something that's very fast-paced, any action, any sports, you have to freeze the moment. So you have to use a faster shutter speed. Now I am in this beautiful location. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use a faster shutter speed somewhere about 1/2000 or 1/4000 or even faster than that. Now what shutter speed you should use depends on how fast the subject is moving. So right now the water is flowing quite fast, so I'm going to start with 1/4000 of a second. I'm going to set my shutter speed first, then I'm going to adjust my ISO. So talking about ISO, depending on the exposure, I will adjust my ISO. I will adjust the ISO till I get a correct exposure and then I will click the button at that exact moment. When we are talking about fast-paced action, not only the settings but also the timing matters for a beautiful shot. So when you're shooting in low light, the problem is the amount of light available is very less. And that is where you have to increase the ISO. But increasing ISO will give you grainier and less quality images. For that, the best thing to do is to use a slower shutter speed. Now, when you're shooting handheld, somewhere about 1/20th or 1/25th of a second is a good slow shutter speed. Adjust the shutter speed and then adjust the ISO. The goal is to use a slower shutter speed and least ISO possible. Make sure that because you're using slower shutter speed, the images are not blurry, right? Just because you want a good quality image, make sure the image is also sharp at the same time. One more thing you can do when shooting in low light is to use a tripod. It will eliminate all the handshakes and it will give you sharper images. You can also try long exposure when you have a tripod. Use a shutter speed of about 10 or 20 seconds depending on the situation and use a lower ISO. Make sure you have set your focus and it doesn't change while taking the image. In low light photography, it is slightly complex, but if you practice, you will master low light photography too. So I hope you understood how to use the pro mode in mobile phones. It's very easy. You have to analyze the light and decide whether you want the shutter speed or ISO to be adjusted first. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you liked it, press the like button. If you're new to the channel and want more content like this, subscribe to the channel. I will talk to you guys in the next one. Bye.